We received a call from a young lady that was in very much a distressful situation. She had been beaten by her husband, and at the same time, the husband had taken the child. It was considered a kidnapping situation. And after talking to the mother, we found out through later investigation that the child had been taken out of the country.
He ended up pushing me down the stairs, and he just left me there. I was hospitalized for 5 days, and I called my father and my mother, and of course they came down, and we couldn't get in to find him anywhere. We called friends, his mom, his dad. We couldn't find him or my daughter. And my father hired a private investigator to try to track his whereabouts. And they ended up finding airline tickets to Mexico.
On this particular case, there was no custody hearing had been held. There was no formal custody awarded to either parent, and indeed there was not even a divorce. So one parent had just as much right to take the child as the other parent. So when the legal procedures failed to render a favorable solution, it was suggested that we or someone be contacted on a professional basis to actually perform an extraction.
It was deemed that we would have to make an infill or entrance into the country by water. We put our team into action. We started training and performing STO, standard training operations, in preparation to execute this mission. It was very rigorous training. We knew that it would be a very difficult entry, and certainly this was not a very easy job. We would require landing at a beach. The training that you see here was performed in daylight hours, but this was deemed to be necessary to have a night assault. We are running through standard infill exercises coming into the beach area. Team leader is ordering the team to the ground. He is, in this particular training exercise, has spotted a sniper on the ridge. We have to go in for neutralization of the sniper and to control this particular area. The team is divided up and in position. What you're viewing here is actual on-the-ground surveillance footage of the area in the country where we had to perform this instruction. This area here shows the rear side of the property.
Last time we're gonna go around this. In 5 minutes, this is gonna be hot.
Divers go in first to provide minute-to-minute intelligence information to ensure that what movement is in the house and where the child is. Extraction team in, which required them to identify any hostiles on the perimeter and take them out of commission. We were able to go into the house and obtain a successful extraction. Once making our way through the house, we located the room where the child was sleeping. We had to administer an anesthetic to the child while she was asleep to keep her remaining to sleep, to prevent her from being hysteric and certainly compromising the mission. We immediately put her into our waterborne craft, checking her vital signs and administering additional drugs to revive her and to ensure she is in good health.
I can feel you. Darkness.
15 April from Germany. We received a telephone call from a woman who was reporting to us that her child had been possibly kidnapped. She wasn't certain. She was very distressed. The child had left for school, 15-year-old girl, that morning, and it had been reported to her that by the school that she had never arrived at the school. A few days later, she received a letter in the mail from her daughter. And although the handwriting was that of her daughter, the message was very unsettling to the mother. Her daughter was revealing to her that she would be gone only for 2 to 3 weeks, a short time. But this was highly unusual because the mother stated that her daughter never did things like this. We advised her to contact the local polizei and to examine the letter, instructing her to be very careful not to tamper with it, but only to have it available for them to look at. At that point, a fingerprint specialist was brought to the site by the polizei to take fingerprints from the letter. They did get a positive, got the print, a latent print removed. However, it did not match that of her daughter, Tanya. Next suggestion was to try the postage stamp and to attempt to get a DNA sample from that, from her saliva on there. This required also taking a control sample, her toothbrush, which was then sent to the lab to see if we could get a DNA match between the toothbrush and the saliva on the back of the postage stamp. We had a match. We knew factually that Tanya had in fact been in possession of that letter. We put our team immediately into action and deployed to the area in Germany to begin preliminary investigations. On the ground, part of our work was to contact one of our specialists, which is an internet specialist. We have knowledge of these things, that typically when young girls are taken, especially in this manner, it is quite customary that they are sold into some sex trade industry or into the internet child pornography. We found a picture of Tanya on the internet. We traced this link back to the Netherlands area, deployed part of our team to look at investigative actions there. I went back to meet with the mother and described to her what we had found. We had traced the link to the Netherlands and that we were in the process of investigating. I tried to console the mother, ensuring her that we would make every effort to recover her child. But typically, I had to be honest with her, in these scenarios, when young girls are taken or young children are taken away, it is usually ends up in a fatality. This is unlike prostitution, where they would be used and used over again as long as possible. Here, it is very typical to use these young girls in child pornography and then literally dispose of them. However, I explained to the mother, I was very touched by this scenario. I tried to maintain a very sterile approach to my business. However, I became emotionally involved with this scenario and admitted to the mother that I go personally to this area to see what can be done. We perform additional searches in Germany, then we have to go to the Netherlands. All the while, only thought on my mind is finding this girl and hopefully finding her before it's too late. Even though inside it is telling me it's already too late, but yet we go anyway and perform an exhaustive search of the area. We are able to narrow down different sectors and have made determinations that in the red light district area, There had been reports of a girl fitting that description had been seen. This area takes on a totally different view at night. In the day, it is quite much a casual sleeping town, but at night it comes alive. We traced her to a particular area in this district where a lot of this activity takes place. However, my worst fears were realized. Only 2 days later, the body of the young girl was discovered. Received a call from a gentleman in Germany who had a very unfortunate experience. After returning home one day, he found that his wife and his entire family was gone without the trace. And he had no idea what had occurred to them. We met with the individual and began to discuss his problem, and he told us of his three children. After a preliminary investigation, we found that his wife had willingly taken the children from the country and had gone away with her paramour, with a lover that he was completely unaware of, and had left the country. This provided a great deal of stress to the father. He was very much in psychological shock about this, very distressed. Only wanted his children returned. And his entire thinking is only about his children. His wife, he finds that she's not only left the country, but has gone to South Africa, to the Cape Town area. He then personally goes himself to look for his wife and his children. This is very much a futile effort for him. He has no trained professionals, and he is literally looking for a needle in a haystack. We are contacted then to try to provide services, because he was unsuccessful. And we find that the entire group has left South Africa, made their way to Puerto Rico, and then finally to Miami. We located the wife and three children, along with her lover, have been located in the United States. Based on our surveillance, they are still remaining in Miami at this time. There are no formal court hearings that have been completed, so there is no authorization to remove these individuals and return them to the father. Once a custody hearing has been completed in Germany, then it will be possible for us to bring the children back to Germany.
There you have it. I saw it. Hans Allman, bullet catcher. Good guy, bad guy. Depends on what side you're on. I'll see you next time.